Hi, I'm Chris, and I'm searching for the Higgs boson decaying to two bottom quarks in association with a W or Z boson. B quarks produced at LHC from Higgs bosons or otherwise quickly form into short-lived particles called B hadrons. These have lifetimes that are short enough to see in the same snapshot as that of the collision, and they don't travel far enough to reach the outside of the detector. When they finally decay, B hadrons, numerous particles are produced. Those reconstructed particles point back to the origin of the B decay, which is separated from the original collision by a few centimeters. There are so many real background events with two B quarks that the strategy for saving events like this must be based on what else is going on in the event. The most sensitive strategy is to select events where a W or Z boson decays with easily reconstructed particles. 58% of Higgs bosons will decay to two bottom quarks, and yet, because of the very large backgrounds at LHC, we are only reaching observation sensitivity in the two bottom quark channel now. But this search is part of a much longer historical arc. This was the search at LEP and Tevatron, where lower masses of the Higgs boson were sought. If the Higgs boson mass were smaller, the fraction of decays to bottom quarks would be even larger, making it almost the only decay channel relevant to search for. In addition to providing direct observation of the Higgs boson interaction with quarks, the two bottom quark with W or Z boson search yields the best measurements of these production processes and this decay process. Finally, nailing down the biggest fraction of Higgs boson decays will constrain the total Higgs width measurement. Making these essential measurements of the Higgs boson properties is a fitting capstone to this decades-long search.